Hi crafty friends, it's Jeannie, and today I'm sharing three cards using this Trinity Stamps 3x4 stamp set, and the name is called Purrachute. So it's a punny name for a cat in a parachute, and I thought it would be perfect to show you guys how to use one of the smaller stamp sets multiple ways, and hopefully it provides you some great ideas. So I'm starting off with my first card using this cloud die from the Rainbow Die stamp set. And I'm cutting an A2 card panel in four pieces. For each of the pieces, I'm going to go in and add distress ink at the very bottom of the cloud. So when I piece it together, it is blue sky. So it looks really cool. Of course, you can use a stencil to create the same effect, but I thought it'd be nice to just die cut it together. It made it very easy to do. For the cat image itself, I will be showing my coloring once. I do color all three cats for all three cards differently, and I use different color combinations, but I thought that you just needed to see my coloring once, and you can use the same combinations and incorporate them into the different cats. But I will have all the colors I use listed down below. And I tend to color my cats in normal colors. I use orange, brown, and gray. I just can't make myself color a cat purple for some reason. Maybe one day, but I think that's just outside my comfort zone. I just can't do it right now. I also don't like too much color. So if I were to color the cat purple, then I wouldn't even know what to color the parachute. I would just end up going with neutrals or something like that. So that's why I tend to stick with the normal colors. But I know that there's a lot of artists out there that love to use random colors for critters, and I totally appreciate that, and I love that they can do it. I just haven't gotten myself to be able to do that because I just don't know what to color their accessories. Like, what would I color the parachute if my cat was purple? I don't know, maybe it's just me, but that's just how I feel. So I am including the coloring once. I thought this cat was so funny because I actually had watched this show on TV. It's a revenge prank with Pauly D and Vinny from Jersey Shore, and they play pranks on for other people. And the first episode of this series was this husband pranking his wife by skydiving, and he is a dummy that just falls to the ground and it freaks her out. And she was such a good sport about it because she was just really upset but really glad he was alive and not, you know, smushed on the ground. So for that card panel, I just piece all the little cloud pieces together. And for the sentiment, I am using the same pinks that I use in the parachute for the sentiment. And I will be die cutting it. The coordinating dies that come with this set include the sentiment dies, which cut them out individually. And I really like that because a sentiment strip is easy to stamp and trim, but cutting the words up evenly is a little bit harder sometimes, especially when sentiments are really small and they're stuck together. So I really appreciate the sentiment being able to cut out these little pieces. And I thought it was perfect for this particular card because I can just scatter it around the card panel. There was a bit of empty space, so I pulled out Trinity Stamps embellishments. These are called bubble blowers. They're just iridescent bubbles that I've added just for a little bit of interest to the card. And my embellishment tray, if you can see, is like this heart embellishment that's super cute. I'll link the Etsy store I got it from down below. For my second card, I wanted to do something pretty simple. I am just stenciling a circle with clouds and adding the little kitty image to the side of it. So I am using Trinity Stamps A2 Foundation Circle Stencil and taping it to the card panel. I have used this in another video where I used the rectangle ones to create three ink blended backgrounds for a large floral image. And this one is the same technique. I am just using it so I don't have to mask off. I'm mixing purple and pink for the clouds. I use the same rainbow die cut to create this faux stencil out of cardstock. I will let you know that because this rainbow die has stitching on it, the ink does show up through the stitched areas. So if that bothers you, don't use it. But for me, I inked blended the color so lightly on that you can barely see the stitching, and I don't mind. It kind of just adds a little something extra to it. So I thought that this card with the image was going to be a little too much green and yellow color because it was so vibrant. So I actually trimmed down the card panel a quarter of an inch and then another 1/8 of an inch. And I used that 1/8 strip, colored it up with the green Copic marker that I used to color his parachute. And then I'm putting it all on this yellow piece of cardstock. I thought that that really tied the whole card together. I'm also pulling out this washi tape from Doodlebug, and I've used this in several of my cards. It's just a nice accent that pulls in the sentiment strip on black together. So I'll just put everything together, and I think that that really works. For the sentiment strip, I just stamped it on black cardstock and heat embossed it on white. I think that the sentiment strip really matches with that washi tape. It really pulls in the black, and I'm able to pull in the yellow and the green just from the side of that particular card. So it really came together and I loved it. For this third card background, I had been inspired by a card that I saw from Kelly Ladavola, and she had this stamp set from Neat and Tangled, and I just don't have that. So I decided that I was just going to color up this aerial view of the earth using Copic markers in the same color blocking way that she did it. She used the stamp. It had a ton of lines, but she kind of just did her own thing with it and used it as a guide. So I kind of just freehanded this. I didn't know how it was going to turn out. I tend to really like ink blending, and I am bothered when things aren't blended properly. But for this technique, it worked out really well. I think the only thing that I would change about this is to go in with a little bit lighter of a green. My darkest green was pretty dark, and so I did go in to try to blend it out a little bit because I thought the green was a little too harsh. So I am just going in and adding the lightest color, then going to the medium color, and then the darkest color. And I'm creating these little blocks of land, of grass, water, and I think that it looked really cool. However, I thought that once I finished the card panel, there was something missing. So again, I will pull out that rainbow die to add these clouds to the sky image. And I don't know if you've gone skydiving. I have, and it was an amazing experience. I really, really enjoyed it. I did it in Hawaii, and it was something I wanted to do again, but I just haven't had the chance to. I don't want to do it in California. Hawaii was my bucket list of where I would go skydiving, and I'm so glad I was able to do that. It's super scary, but it was such a rush. It was so fun. But I can still remember the view from up in the sky coming down in Hawaii. It was just so gorgeous. You saw the ocean, you saw the land. It was just amazing. So for the clouds that I wanted to add, I used the dies from the rainbow set and I cut them out on vellum. But before I did that, I used the vellum on Stick-It paper, which is a double-sided adhesive that just adds adhesive to any surface. So for this case, I wanted to add it to the vellum because if you were to put like glue on vellum, you'd be able to see the glue marks, and I just wanted the entire area to be covered with adhesive. So I cut out four of these little cloud panels, and I'm just adhering it to the border and the corners of this card, and I think that it just really pulled the card together. It makes it look a little bit better I know that because it's not super blended, it was kind of bothering me, and this kind of covers it up or softens it a little bit, and I really like how it turned out. This was a card that definitely was different from what I normally do. I even considered ink blending this, but I just didn't think it would come out with the same sharpness, so I didn't and used Copics instead. It's pretty cool, I think. I don't know. I don't know which background I like the most. So if you guys have an opinion, let me know. But I think that this one is definitely outside my comfort zone for creating a background just fully out of Copic markers. I'm really looking into learning how to create backgrounds with just Copic markers, but it's a work in progress. That's it for the third card, and I hope you enjoyed all three cards and it gave you some ideas of how to use this 3x4 stamp set. I'll see you guys next time.